In this how-to video, we'll cover the DIY basic installation and operation of our Iron Horse shaft mount gearbox backstop assembly. Gearbox backstops are used in applications where the load is significant enough that should a stop occur, a potential reversing condition can be prevented. An example of this might be a large incline conveyor application moving heavy material long distances. A backstop installed onto the gearbox will prevent the conveyor from rolling backwards in the event of a failure or stop. Backstop assemblies are designed to protect the gearbox and the motor from being rotated and possibly oversped in the wrong direction, where the conveyor could potentially accelerate to a runaway condition, causing harm and damage to persons or equipment. If other items like sprockets, chains, belts, keys, or keyways between the gearbox and the conveyor fail, the backstop does not play a role in conveyor movement. Notice, when using a backstop, do not use other brand backstops in our Iron Horse gearboxes, and do not use Automation Direct's Iron Horse backstops on any other brand gearbox. Backstops are precision safety devices designed to operate in certain gearboxes. Interchanging brand parts may cause them to operate incorrectly, which can result in an unsafe condition, destroy the gearbox, or void the manufacturer's warranty. Prior to installation, please review the manuals provided for these Iron Horse gearboxes and accessories. They can be found on our website at automationdirect.com. In the backstop assembly, you'll find a backstop key, and possibly a circlip depending on backstop assembly size. The example I'm using today is a size 2, and it does not contain or utilize a circlip. If you're using a backstop with a circlip or C-clip, circlip or C-clip pliers will be required. Make sure the gearbox has been drained of oil, or gear oil will pour out when the cover is removed. Be careful removing the cover not to damage the gasket. Begin by removing the 4 Allen screws from the input shaft cover. Removal of the cover exposes the back side of the input shaft. This is where the backstop is installed. Here we can identify the keyway location. When looking at the backstop, the rotation direction is etched onto the outer race. Determine which direction the gearbox shaft should rotate and install the backstop accordingly. The rotation arrow is marked illustrating the outer race's free direction. The gearbox shaft direction will turn in the opposite direction of the arrow on the backstop race. When installing the backstop, simply press the backstop onto the input shaft. Align the keyways, install the key, and press the backstop completely into place. The backstop may need to be tapped gently into place. If using a hammer, it is suggested to use a soft hammer like the one being used here. Before reassembling the cover and gasket, double-check the input and output shaft rotation by hand. Once the rotation direction is confirmed in the correct direction, reinstall the gasket and backstop cover plate with the Allen bolts removed earlier. Refill the gearbox with the appropriate type and amount of oil, and the gearbox is ready for installation. When the electric motor is first connected to power, it is extremely important that the electrician test the rotation of the motor disconnected from the input shaft of the gearbox. This will reduce damage in the unlikely event the motor is connected up in a reverse rotation and is powered up with a rotation in the backstop direction. Removal of the backstop is simple. Reverse the order of assembly. If you have any questions about using Automation Direct's Iron Horse gearboxes, please contact Automation Direct's free award-winning technical support team during regular business hours. They'll be happy to help. Click on this short video to learn more about Automation Direct support options, and click here to learn more or see more videos on the Iron Horse products. And be sure to click here to subscribe to our YouTube channel to be notified of new videos. And don't forget to hit the like button below.